There is really no typical day in a registered architect's life. However, for an architecture intern, my days were pretty much the same. Today, I will be going over what it was like to work at an architecture firm because I did observe what the licensed architects actually do in comparison to me, and we'll just get right into it. It is your girl Nat here. Please be sure to join our Discord if you are interested. So, client meetings for the architects of the firm. My bosses were always traveling, going around the country to meet with new clients, prospective clients, wining and dining clients, site visits, which I'll talk about in a little bit, and all this fun stuff, right? Now, I know travel, like if you don't like traveling, maybe going through TSA every single time you travel could be quite annoying, but it is still a really cool part of architecture and the field as a whole is that when you own your own firm or really high up on the ladder, it is your job to wine and dine clients and go out, and, you know, just really explore the site. But back at the firm, they were always in client meetings, talking to their current clients, having meetings. It wasn't just the client and the architect either. There was typically always somebody from interior sitting in, the project manager, of course, any architects that know enough about the project to be sitting in on that meeting. And they just talked about the project, what the client liked, didn't like, all that good stuff. And once the client leaves and the meeting is over, the marketing manager might hop in really quick just to see how they could advertise the current project for the firm, wherever you're at. I don't know where you're at. But for the interns, I was busy drawing construction documents and doing bathroom details, site visits. So, like I mentioned with the first point, architects typically went to go on site visits. In the pre-design phase, typically you have to measure the site, right? Just to see what you're working with, and that typically always includes a site visit. Sure, you can send photos or dimensions could be sent to you, but my firm always felt it was best and more beneficial for the architect or project manager to fly out wherever it was or drive out wherever it is to see the site and take dimensions and all that stuff. So if you really like traveling, taking site dimensions, always a good thing. A common company at my firm work with was called Velvet Taco, and a lot of their stuff is based in Texas. So there was this one architect at the firm who was always going back and forth between Columbus and Texas, which is pretty cool, and that's all on paid company time too. Pretty cool. And if it was a really big prospective client, my bosses would go and wine and dine them at like really fancy restaurants, just trying to get their commission, their work for our firm. And for the interns, I was busy drafting construction documents and doing bathroom details while all of this was going on. I will say, however, though, in my year of interning, I did one solo site visit. Had a blast. I had to measure everything. I modeled it later in Revit. It felt like my own little, you know, project. I was super proud of it, but whatever. It was a blast. So now, creative work. What do architects do? After visiting the site, getting the intern to probably model the site, I probably did that. They would start out with the design work. You know, what massings work best with the site? What does the client want? How could this fit the requirements, the building requirements, all that good stuff. And they would have multiple meetings with other architects in the firm and just determine, you know, is this the best solution for the client? And honestly, this is like the fun part of architecture to me, at least, because in a way, this phase is almost like a studio project, which we spend majority, architecture students in general, spend majority of their time working out the kinks of studio projects, and this is exactly what's going on here. And for the interns, I was busy drafting construction documents and doing bathroom details. That's what I was doing when they were doing the fun stuff. And construction documents. I don't want to appear like the architects, the licensed architects, never touched construction documents. That is not the case at all. They did a lot of the design work in Revit, and it would be my job to set up all of the sheets because that's kind of monotonous, like anyone can do it, that kind of thing. But if something wasn't working in the floor plan, they would rework the floor plan, make sure the circulation looks top notch, top tier. The interiors department would also work in the same cloud Revit model and just make sure everything looks great, everything's designed nicely, and the user experience is fantastic. I don't want to appear the architects don't do the boring stuff, and also it's all subjective, like what's boring to you, but they would still contribute a lot to the Revit model, obviously, and the construction document phase, and they have to review all the construction documents before they sign it for a permit just to double check everything testing and make sure that they don't get sued. They still kind of do the monotonous, tedious kind of work too. But also during this phase for the interns, I was still doing construction documents and drawing bathroom details. Woo. And also setting up sheets. I did a lot of that too. 3D models. Now, licensed architects, if they want to do a 3D model, they could, I'm assuming. Most firms might have a 3D modeling department at their firm, which is really cool. And a lot of them are completely self-sufficient. So they'll have a bunch of 3D printers, their own CNC router, their own laser cutters, all that really cool stuff, their own wood shop. Super, super cool. I remember touring a couple firms based in Columbus and they were really cool to see, and the models that they were producing was insane, top-notch quality. It's just one guy or a couple of people there who were producing all the models for the whole firm. They didn't really touch any of the design stuff. It was more so that the architect would hand the 3D modeling stuff to this in-house model maker. As an intern, you could have the option to help out with this model making. I feel, and I hate generalizing, I feel like most licensed architects actually don't like model making a lot. At least in my experience, whenever I talk to a licensed architect, they're like, oh God, no, please. And they'll just kind of toss it off to the intern or the in-house model maker, whoever's there, so. But still at the same time for the interns, I was busy drafting construction documents and doing bathroom details while the architect was either model making or handing it off to the in-house model maker. Legalities. Architects get sued, and there are a lot of code requirements and expectations for a building, and there's so many ordinances that architects have to be aware of and constantly updating and keeping up to date on the new edits for these ordinances. And this is the one part of architecture that I'm not jealous about, because the architects put themselves on the line anytime that they sign a construction document set and building permits, just because if something were to go wrong or something was overlooked or a minor detail was overlooked or something wasn't properly dimensioned, people are gonna come back to the architect and be like, you drew this wrong, or something wasn't up to code properly. So there's a lot of double checking absolutely everything. Now sure, the architect determines how it's built, what it looks like, what building materials it looks like, but your knowledge of construction has to be pretty vast and pretty contemporary too. But while the architect was busy learning about code or updating code violations in their current projects, guess what the intern was doing? I was doing construction documents and drawing bathroom details. Woo! Overall, life as an architect and life as an architecture intern, at least in my experiences, are pretty different. Now, every firm's gonna be different. This is just my first internship and basically how it went for me. I would strongly recommend, if you are, you know, freshman, sophomore, undergrad, architecture student, please get out there and start interning. Talk to as many people as you can, network as much as you can, go to happy hours, do all this really good networking stuff. Determine if the world of architecture is in fact the right path for you. I feel like every licensed architect's enemy was upcoming deadlines. I mean, my firm was actually pretty good about meeting deadlines, I would say. There's so many deadlines, there's a lot of external stresses going on too. So perhaps the professional field isn't the major for you. And that's why it is so important that you start interning early, because I was a senior when I got my first architecture internship, and I feel like I was kind of late too. But what if I hated it? What if I hated like the professional world? Then I would feel as if I wasted 4 years and a degree in architecture, which really wouldn't give me anything, especially if I didn't want to go practice in the world of architecture. You know what I mean? Go intern and let me know how it goes and where you're at and what your dream firm is that you want to work at. And if you yourself has interned in the past, leave a comment down below. What was your experience like? I feel like the majority of me and my friends who were first year interns, we kind of did a lot of work in Revit, and we were kind of low man on the totem pole here. So I don't want to dissuade anyone from studying architecture or practicing architecture. I'm just trying to give you a really honest reveal of what it was like for me to intern in Columbus, Ohio. The reason I stopped interning is because of COVID-19. Anyway, that is it for today's video. Please be sure to like, subscribe, join our Discord, and I will see you guys in the next video. Love you guys.